Hey everyone, so in this video I'll be making 5 different recipes inspired by Quentin Tarantino films, all veganized. This was really, really fun to make and I can't wait for you guys to see it. So if you liked it, give it a big thumbs up and I'll see you guys after the video. Also, if you're one of my friends, don't make too much fun of me. Thank you.
Yeah. Big Kahuna Burger. That's that Hawaiian burger joint.
Okay guys, so the ingredients that I used to recreate the Big Kahuna Burger were hamburger buns, Beyond Beef, BioLife cheddar slices, iceberg lettuce, and a Sprite tube on the side. So I fried up a flattened Beyond Burger, put a piece of BioLife cheese on it, and let it melt over the sides just like the real Kahuna Burger. I put a piece of iceberg lettuce on top, lots of ketchup because it's the best condiment, and smushed the bun right on top, which gave it a very good fast food look. Yeah, I mean, it looks pretty close to the original, so I was pretty proud of myself. Then I added some Alexia Yukon Gold fries to the side, which were obviously great. Yeah, this is a pretty easy recreation, so it was great in all aspects. What I didn't show in this video is the Sprite exploding all over me, which just added to my hatred of soda. So in all, really enjoyed except for that part of it. Okay, so for Shoshana Strudel, I started off with puff pastry, whipped topping, 2 apples, and some cinnamon. So after slicing all the apples very thin, I mixed it with some cinnamon and I put them right on top of the puff pastry. I then folded over the puff pastry and enclosed all the sides, which didn't look that pretty, but it worked. And then after that, I put it on a baking sheet and put it in the oven for around 15 minutes. And it came out nice and golden brown. I definitely should have baked it for a little bit longer, but it still was very good, a little bit soft. And the inside was super stacked and pretty. And so I was happy with how it turned out. My whole family liked it as well, especially with that whipped topping I never tried it before. And yes, it looked so pretty, so I couldn't stop taking pictures of it. But I'm really glad that I tried this recipe because it was super easy, only 3 ingredients from the Elephantastic Vegan. I'll put the recipe in the description.
White cake.
So for the white cake recipe, I added flour, sugar, baking powder, and salt to a bowl. I mixed that all up and then added some macadamia milk, never used that before, but it was good, some canola oil, and some clear vanilla flavor. That was kind of the trick to making it all very clear and white. Mixed that up, and I divided this batter into 3 tins. So I had to 1.5 the recipe because it was made for 2 tins. I placed those in the oven for 30 minutes, probably a little bit too long, but that's okay. And this is me making the icing, which was just powdered sugar, macadamia milk again, the clear vanilla flavor, and some vegan butter. I mixed that all up, adding a little bit more macadamia milk, and then it was time to frost and assemble. So I placed all of the frosting on top. It doesn't look too pretty, but it was still okay. I smoothed it all out, put all 3 layers on top of each other, and eventually it came together. Okay, so this is the finished product. Not too pretty, but it worked. I cut a slice into it, and this was probably the nicest part because it actually made two very distinct layers, or three very distinct layers, and put that right on a plate. China again, because, you know, that's probably what they had in the movie, and ate that while watching the movie. It was really, really good. Alright, so for the $5 shake, I used Oatly vanilla ice cream, a whole carton, and pressed that down in the blender. I then had to add milk, so I chose vanilla ripple, that's my dad's favorite milk, and blended that all up, which took a little bit because it was kind of thick, but it actually worked out. And I placed that all into a tall beer glass, also for my dad's collection. Which, I don't know, I think it worked. It was tall and milkshake-like. I placed some more of that plant-based topping on top of it, and it was super nice and looked pretty much like the original shake. Obviously, I had to add a cherry on top because, you know, that's iconic. And I liked how it turned out. I think Uma Thurman would approve.
I don't know if it was worth $5, but it was pretty fucking good.
Yeah. It hurts. It hurts her. It shouldn't hurt. You know, her pussy should be bubbling up by now. But when this cat fucks her, it hurts. It hurts just like it did.
Guys, sorry for including that scene. I know it's kind of weird, but, you know, I feel like it had to happen. Anyway, this scene doesn't actually focus on food at all, just a little bit of coffee talk, but I didn't even have coffee. We decided to go to Veggie Galaxy in Cambridge to pick up some diner food. So I got some home fries, an omelet. Jesse and I actually got some vinyl records in Cambridge, so we listened to those when we got home. And I also got French toast with chocolate chips and banana butter, which were insanely good. Probably not what they ate, but you know, like, you just have to go for it. If you go to Veggie Galaxy, you gotta get the best stuff. And I enjoyed that and even let my brother in. He was dancing to one of the records that we got. He liked the French toast a lot as well. So yeah, it was a better choice than me making my own breakfast for us because I wouldn't have been as good. And now he's doing the Cotton Eye Joe, which, you know, it works, it works.
Hey.
Jesse and I, of course, paid our 15% tip, but there's someone that didn't chip in, unfortunately. Yeah. Okay, for this one, I literally just made instant mac and cheese, so it was super easy. Just boiled some water with some salt. I was using Bonza plant-based mac and cheese, added that to the boiling water, and then let that boil, and then put it in a colander. I put the glowing pasta back into the pot and added the cheese powder. I didn't add any milk because it didn't look like he did. Maybe now he did, I don't know. But anyways, I didn't, and I tried it, and it was super mediocre. Thanks for watching, everybody.
Make sure to like and subscribe.
Bye.
And then, boom.